And now a woman I've not met, president, the international president of SEIU, Mary Kay Henry. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. I am honored to be here today to help break the silence against workplace bullying. And I am here, Dr. Namy, because of one of our local leaders who has had the strength, Greg Sorensen, National Vice President of NAGE, and our President of NAGE in the back there, David Hallway, and one of his other executive board members, Jane Bethel, are the people that brought SEIU's work on this issue to the forefront. And it is really important to us as we think about not only the 2.1 million members that we represent in SEIU, but all working people, that this is a part of a larger social and economic justice fight that is going to get tackled on two fronts. One is in the workplace, as we just heard from the Vice President of the NAACP, Hillary Shelton, and the other is making it possible for every parent to have the resources they need to raise children in a loving environment and not be stressed out from stitching together 2 to 3 low-wage jobs so that we can break the cycle of violence that we experience as young people. Too often, SEIU members are told that workplace bullying is just a part of the job. And they are often hear this same sentiment when they have to witness a worker in their workplace being beaten, or even killed on the job. But you and I both know that no working person went into their profession or were called to serve with the mindset that bullying or violence was just part of what they did on the job. We firmly believe that it is critically important for employers to explicitly address workplace bullying at each and every level of a successful labor management partnership. And at a minimum, we are seeking with every employer that we negotiate with a bullying agreement that includes a commitment from both management and the employees to be involved in ending workplace bullying, a comprehensive system to evaluate the worksite risks, and clear options to report threatening or abusive behavior. And that's why working people, whether union or non-union, share a basic principle of fairness and equality. We believe that each and every human being is deserved to be treated with dignity and respect, and that all work should be valued in this economy, and that workplace bullying flies in the face of that value and our desire to feel safe and protected in the workplace. Workplace bullying impacts the overall work environment, not just the victim and the abuser. It has been our experience that when management, workers, and labor commit to changing the culture of a workplace, workers can feel a real impact in terms of their ability to thrive and provide the kind of quality care and services that every worker wants to be able to provide each and every day. And that respect and civility are basic values, that the notion of bullying as just being part of the job is completely unacceptable. And we want to commit every level of SEIU leadership to making sure that in our generation, we leave a workplace free from this kind of behavior to the next generation. And I want to commend the Workplace Bullying Institute and the leadership of you, Dr. Gary Namy, on this issue. It is critical that working people everywhere have the ability to go to work and be able to do their job in a comfortable and safe and healthy environment. And we are going to commit our resources together with our allies here, the rest of the labor movement, the NAACP, and people that care about basic dignity and respect for all human beings. Thank you very much.
Thank you, President Henry. She said a very key thing, dignity at work, and it's an assumption that we make, you realize. And in this modern contemporary era, the people who are running our world and establishing the work conditions feel it's something that has to be earned. We don't agree with that. You start with dignity, and it's been taken away. So enough is enough already. Thank you for your support, and SEIU Locals have been very active in California and been in contact with us. They're doing tremendous things in counties and pushing the employers to stop it. By the way, no good employer should fear any efforts, any anti-bullying efforts. If you have to be abusive to run your workplace, if that's how you manage, you shouldn't even be flipping burgers anywhere. And that's not to degrade burger flipping by any means.